This quadcopter belongs to a friend of mine, and he has been trying to get it working for a long freaking time. And he kept coming and asking me for advice, and I would make a suggestion, and then I'd see him a few weeks later, and he'd still be working on it. And finally, I went, "Take a hint, Joshua." And I said, "Can I just fix it for you?" And I guess that's my instinct, is always to try to help other people fix things. But sometimes you try to teach a man to fish, but sometimes you just give him a fish. And that's what we're doing today. I want to take you through the process of trying to fix this thing. What is it? Who cares? It doesn't really matter. What problem is it having? Here's the problem it's having. Oh, by the way, I'm Joshua Bardwell. You're going to learn something today. I know you guys hate it when I skip the intro. Here's the problem. We go to the motors tab. I understand the risk props are off, and I'm going to raise the motor slider here. And the front left motor is not spinning. Okay, so that's the problem we got to troubleshoot. The very next thing I do in a situation like that is I pinch the motor in my hand and I plug the battery in. And what you're doing is you are feeling for the beeps that the motor makes when it first powers up. Well, that the ESC makes. When you plug in the battery and you hear doot-doot-doot, doot-doot, that's actually the ESC using the motors like a speaker coil. The motor is actually what's making that sound. And you can feel the vibrations. And you want to feel what it's doing. So let me just pinch it and plug in. And what I felt there is that the motor made the first three beeps, doot-doot-doot, but not the second two, doot-doot. So here's what that means. When the ESC first gets power, it goes doot-doot-doot, and it'll do that. If you could just solder a motor up to an ESC on the bench, not even in a quadcopter, no flight controller, you plug in the battery and it goes doot-doot-doot. If you ever plug in and an ESC doesn't go doot-doot-doot, it is dead. The output side, at least, is dead. You might still be able to connect to the logic side via BLHeli and configure it, but it is not able to drive the motor. Now, in this case, I felt it go doot-doot-doot, and that tells me that the ESC is most likely alive, at least the driver side, the output side of the ESC is alive. But it did not go doot-doot, and the doot-doot means that the ESC is seeing a signal from the flight controller. So, what could cause the ESC not to see a signal from the flight controller? Well, over here in the configuration tab, we can take a look at the motor protocol. And if the motor protocol was set to something like, well, it could be set to disabled. On newer versions of Betaflight, you can actually just disable it entirely. Or it could be set to a protocol that this ESC doesn't recognize. Like if you had a super old ESC and you set it to D-shot, but the ESC didn't support D-shot, then you could get no doot doot. Now that's clearly not true. We have D-shot 600 set here, and we know that the ESC understands that protocol because the other three motors, the other three ESCs beeped. This is a 4-in-1 ESC. If one of them supports D-shot, we know that all the others must as well. We could think that through even a little further. These days, all ESCs pretty much support D-shot, but you know what they don't all support? Bidirectional D-shot. Especially if you have BLHeli S ESCs or an older BLHeli 32 ESC, if you were to turn bidirectional D-shot on in Betaflight, you could get a situation where maybe one of the ESCs is on an old firmware and it doesn't recognize that bidirectional D-shot signal, and so you would be missing the doot-doot. Okay, but I think we can assume that this ESC understands D-shot 600. So what else could cause this one motor not to spin, but the others to spin? If we go back to the motors tab, another thing we can check is 1, 2, 3, 4. You see that there are four motors here. There are various configuration things that can happen in Betaflight to cause it to not think that it has four motors. For example, if I go to the configuration tab and I change the mixer to a tricopter mixer, why would you ever do that? I don't know, shush. And then here in the motors tab, we would only have three motors. Well, that certainly would cause the fourth motor not to spin. Well, that's clearly not what's going on here anyway, but it's worth pointing out that one thing you should check if you've ever got a motor that isn't spinning is to go to the motors tab and just look that there are 1, 2, 3, 4 motor sliders here, and sure enough, there are. Now, there's another thing we could check that I'm not going to do right here because it would be a lot of work to set up the camera, but it could be the wiring. This 4-in-1 plug going between the flight controller and the ESC maybe one of the wires is just, maybe it's pinned out wrong, or the wire is broken, or the pin is removed. So you could certainly pull that plug out and give a good physical inspection just to make sure there's no damage. Let's just assume that's not the case. Here's the next thing I'm going to do. I'm going to go to the CLI, and I'm going to wonder if the resource reassignments got messed up. I think he might have been playing with this and trying to like change the resource reassignments. And if you've messed up the motor mapping, then you could end up in a situation where one motor doesn't spin. Rally Nation Talent. Something's not right here. I can't even use the command line. Target Seal Racing F7. I'm not sure. I'm pretty sure this is a Heli Nation Talent F7 flight controller. What's the correct target for this? Legacy Seal Racing F7 target. Ah! Ha 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 ha. All this time, the answer has been right effing here in the effing page of the effing. There's a problem with the Seal Racing F7 target and motor 4 doesn't work. Oh, I'm such an idiot. I've been trying to fix this for him for months. It has it right here on the product page. Oh my God. Okay, official beta flight target is Talon F7 Fusion. Oh God. God almighty. Okay, let's just flush it. Oh, this was so much easier than I thought. I thought this was going to be a deep troubleshooting with resource remapping, but I couldn't get the CLI to work. I don't know why. Probably because he's got an old version of Betaflight on there. And it turns out right here on the product page is the answer. So it looks like they based this design on the Seal Racing F7 target. But then the motor mapping didn't work, so you have to put a resource mapping in. But it actually turns out that what you really need to do is just use the correct Talon F7 Fusion target. So let's do that real quick. Disconnect. Firmware flash error. Oh man. Well, there you go. That's how. Hey, welcome to the troubleshoot. Talon F7 Fusion is the correct target. Talon F7 Fusion. We're going to flash Betaflight 426. He's on Betaflight 4.0, but I don't think that's on purpose. Load firmware. Flash firmware. And I bet you it's going to work now. Configuration. T-Shot 600. Very interesting. I really would have thought that would be disabled, but okay. T-Shot 600. Go to the motors tab. Plug in and pinch that motor, baby. I feel the buzz. And I understand the risks. Propellers are removed. Let's spin that motor. Bingo. All four motors are spinning. Alrighty, folks. Well, I'm going to post this video because that's the beauty of real-world troubleshoots. I mean, I had an idea how I thought this was going to go and what I was going to show you guys, but a real world troubleshoot just is what it is. And in this case, look up the target and see if it's got the right target on it. I only did that because I was going to flash it, because for some reason when I went to the CLI, it wasn't letting me type in the CLI. Let's see if that's fixed. Yeah, it's fixed. For some reason, it wasn't letting me type into the CLI. It was just giving me garbage, and I was like, something's really flaky here. And whenever I've got a situation like that where like just things are super flaky and the board is being weird, I wonder if I just reflash this with the correct target, maybe it has the wrong target on it. Maybe it just needs it's brain wiped. That's what I was going to do anyway. After I checked the configuration, I was going to wipe it and start from scratch. And sure enough, that advice still turned out to work, because the flashing itself wasn't what solved the problem, but going and looking up the correct target is what solved the problem. And, now it's fixed. So that's going to do it for this video. Thanks for watching. Happy flying.
You guys, I don't know where I am, and I don't know what's going to happen, but if I don't make it out of this, I just want to know that you subscribe to my channel. or maybe join my Patreon, or click one of these videos I picked out for you.